Good morning all. So let us welcome to second year practicals. Practicals, that is the second experiment related to the screw gauge. See, screw gauge is an instrument which use it to measure. See, we can measure the more accuracy because screw gauge is in millimeter. That's what here. Screw gauge is used to find the thickness of a given a glass plate. Of course, we can measure the thickness of a given a glass plate. Thickness directly we can get instead of taking length and breadth. So we can take directly thickness by using a screw gauge. And not only that, we can also measure the radius of the given a cylinder. Radius also we can, because sometimes he may ask you find the volume of the given cylinder, or find the radius of the given cylinder, or find the thickness of the given glass plate. Like that, they will ask you question in the final practical exams. Sir, screw gauge, like it is a screw gauge. See, the screw gauge is provided like it is to be like this, right, which can be rotated. See, there is a one scale is there, the scale which can be rotated on the main scale. That is, we can say one is a head scale, we can call. One more is the pitch scale. Sir, which one is head scale? Head scale is nothing but which is moving freely rotating. No, this is the head scale. Okay, you see, this is we can call head scale. Inside there is a scale is there, that we can call pitch scale. So that here is the pitch scale is provided. There are divisions, like a pitch scale is provided. There are some divisions like a 0, 5, 10, like it is given in the millimeters. So that each one is carries a 1 millimeter. Which one? Pitch scale is inside is there, no? That scale we can call pitch scale. So that each which is provided in millimeter and which is moving freely on the pitch scale, that we can call head. It is we can call head scale. That's what we can call HSR. Head scale reading we can call HSR. Here we can write as PSR plus HSR. This is a PSR is nothing but a pitch scale reading. Pitch scale reading, and here head scale is nothing but a, we can call HSR reading. See, which is to be rotated. See, when it is to be closed. See, after closing, we can rotate it. See, once we should rotate, whether it is fixed or not, so that we'll get the one sound. Look at one sound, enough. Now it is closed, it is fixed. See, after fixing, now we have to check this instrument, is there any error? Before going to the experiment, now we have to check this instrument, is there any error? So error in the sense, what will happen? See, look at here on the actually scale, there is the scale which is moving head scale, no? On the head scale, there is a divisions are provided from 0 to like 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. There are millimeter scale is provided up to 100 out there. 100 divisions are there on the which scale? On the head scale. So that if you close it like this, if after closing, once rotation you take like this, after rotating, let us you check. See this 0 on the pitch scale 0. See, remember, pitch scale and head scale, if it is to be coincide like this, pitch scale and head scales are coincide like this. See, on the pitch scale and the head scale, this is head scale. So which are provided 0, 5, 10, 20, 30, like up to 95, then after 100. There are 100 divisions are provided on the head scale. See, look at here, if this head scale 0, if it is coincide with the pitch scale 0 is, therefore we can say there is no error. We can call as the error free it is, no error. We can say zero error, we can say. No error here. Because if it is to be 0 of the pitch scale, which is coincide with the 0 of the head scale, if it is to be coincide, of course. See, some scales it may be coincide, some scales it may not be coincide. So after closing, once you check with me, there is some errors are there. So without error, we can say that head scale 0 is coincide with the pitch scale 0. So that we cannot add anything. We cannot do anything if it is 0. If some errors are there, sir, what will be the error? Suppose you look at here, again you see there is a one pitch scale and one more is the head scale, no? Look at here. See, this head scale is, suppose head scale reading 0 is below the 0 of the pitch scale. That is what we can say. This is the pitch scale 0, no? If हेड स्केल जीरो बिलो द पिच स्केल, बिलो द पिच स्केल जीरो, देन वी कैन से द एरर इज पॉजिटिव. एरर वी कैन से व्हेन जीरो कम्स बिलो द पिच स्केल, दैट्स वी कैन से पिच स्केल बिलो द जीरो, देन वी कैन से दिस इज अ पॉजिटिव जीरो एरर. इफ पॉजिटिव इज गेटिंग देन वी कैन से करेक्शन इज टू बी नेगेटिव. That mean we should subtract the value. This value we can subtract. I'll show you how to subtract. Come to the next one. Suppose if look at here, head scale is zero, above the pitch scale zero, above it is. That means some numbers are above the zero, so that we can call as a negative zero error. Negative zero error. Negative error is there, no? Therefore that we can say corrected with positive. That mean here this numbers we should add here this numbers we should subtract here. So this is the corrections we can take while we are going to start the experiment. We should check the instrument whether the instrument is perfect or not. Is there any zero errors? Is there any positive errors? Is there any negative error that we have to identify? After knowing this, now let us will go to the experiment. So before going to the experiment, we should know again least count of the screw gauge. Least count of the screw gauge is nothing but the formula for the screw gauge is the total reading will be PSR, that is pitch scale reading. PSR is the pitch scale reading plus corrected HSR. That mean if any corrections are there, that we can take corrected HSR. If positive error is there, suppose if a positive error is there we can subtract the value. If negative error is there, then you say there it is to be added the value. That's what we can say corrected HSR. Head scale reading is corrected into least count. It is will get the answer is in millimeters, because the scales are completely in millimeters. That's what will get the more accuracy than vernier. So come to the point is screw gauge is the least count. We can measure like this pitch of the screw. How many numbers each pitch, you see, each pitch is, it is contains a 1 mm it is contains. So that you take as the pitch of the screw is 1 mm by total number divisions on the head scale, that scale which is freely rotating, no? For this, how many numbers are there? 100 numbers are there. So that we'll get the screw gauge least count will be 0.01 mm we can say. Which is we can say 0.001 mm. See, in the previous experiment it is in centimeters, but this experiment is we can say 0.001 mm it is. So which is more accuracy than the vernier. So now let us will start the experiment, how to take the experiment. See, once again this is a very very important, everyone go through this. Let us, I'll tell you the tabular form for this. See, we have again tabular form on the for this screw gauge also, so that here we should note it like this. See, now I am giving the tabular form, note it. So the first of all tabular form, there will be a tabular form for the given. See, like it is we can take. Now I am doing the first one is to find the thickness of a glass plate. Question is find the thickness of the glass plate, right? We can say T. So thickness we need to find, and the least count of the screw gauge is screw gauge is 0.01 mm it is. Now let us again you write serial number that we too should take the 3 or 4 reading with the same instrument, with the same given plate. It is A you say in mm it is. Second one, head scale reading. That is we can say first one observed value, because we have to know if there is any error is there, that we can say corrected value. That's what we can say, it is a B. And the least count, that is extra fraction, same extra fraction we can say B is equal to N into least count. And your total reading, of course total reading it is that is we can say a plus b in mm, millimeter it is. It is a tabular form. Again, we should take the readings and we should keep in our mind, if any errors are there, then we can go like this. If there is no errors, it's not required, directly we can take it. Directly observed value we can. If there is an errors are there, therefore that we can correct it. That we can correct it. If any errors are there like this, if there is no error, you can go directly. Again, you can do with the experiment with this, right? Now here, let us we'll start the experiment to be like this. Now I am finding the thickness. You take the glass plate, see, which is to be fixed between the two, given these two cylinders. We can also call this is a cylinders, and it is after fitting like this, right? And we can rotate it one time because it is now fixed. So now we have to see the readings. See, how we'll get the readings? See, the readings will be to find the thickness of a given a scale, or sorry, given a thickness. Now we have to see the this scale. So this head scale is there, no? This head scale is coincide with the pitch scale rate. Pitch scale, this head scale here is a given a number, no? This numbers, one of the number is coincide with the head scale. I'm sorry, pitch scale it is. Head scale reading is, head scale reading is on the head scale, there are numbers are provided, no? That number, in that one number, it is coincide with the with the which scale it is, pitch scale. So that this head scale is, we are observing the head scale reading. That's what we can call head scale. PSR is nothing but they will give you the number here. The number here we should write. I'll tell you. I'll write it and I'll show you. So observed head scale is nothing but suppose in my hand, this is showing the number is. See, for this I'll tell you one number is, which is given. Right, so for this you take a in mm a is here for me the instrument is showing the two number, which one? That is the PSR inside. Inside is there, no? That PSR is showing the two number. You write as the number, it is a two, with it is coinciding with the two. Inside scale is there, no? That is we can say pitch scale reading. And eddy scale, which we are observing, suppose it is an error free, directly you write here. But with me there is an error is there. That is error is, we can say positive error is there, that we can say positive error, then we can correct it minus. So the given instrument error will be, you say error is given as plus 2, error positive, the correction we can take as the negative it is. Getting my points? So this is very very important, everyone, it is note down like this, right? So by using this, now I am seeing the head scale reading. This head scale is showing the observed value is, here it is showing the 42. This scale is 42, number is coinciding with the pitch scale. Therefore, you write observed value is 42. Clear? Observed value is 42. Now, corrected value will be what happens? We can correct it minus, because the error is positive, no? When error is positive, we can subtract it. Then after subtraction, we are getting a like this. Now, we can take as what now? Least count. Least count is nothing but a 40 into 0.01 here. So that we may get the 0.04 it is. So A plus B, that is you add both A plus B, that is 2 plus 0.40. We may get 2.40. What it is? It is about a thickness of a given a glass plate for the first reading. Again, once again you remove it. Again, same way you do, you fix it. After fixing, you rotate it. Again, you see the same way. First of all, we should know the pitch scale reading, PSR. So the PSR value is coinciding. This PSR is coinciding with the, see, that is we can say PSR is coinciding with the head scale. So that PSR reading we should know. That PSR we can see. Again, it is maybe same too, but head scale number is coinciding 43 with the PSR is 2. That's what you say. Here it is, you write as second one, 2 it is, 43 is the observed value. What will be the correction now? You say 41. least count will be 41 into 0.01, then we'll get the, it is approximately 0.41, you add it is 2.41 will get. Clear? Now again you remove this, you take 3 or 4 readings like this. Again same, you see first of all, head scale number coinciding with the PSR, pitch scale, that we have to see. Again, we may get the same, of course, it is third one. You say it is coinciding PSR with coinciding is, you say 2, and this may be 43. Again, you take fourth one also 2, 43 it is. So, corrected is 41, corrected is 41, it is 0.41, so 2.41. Now, you take an average value. Average value of the glass plate. We may get the average value is, add all, whatever you are given is, you note down this all and together and divide with that number. Okay? Yeah, we'll go for this. We can take like this, you add all numbers. So it may be average thickness of a glass plate. You write as average thickness of a glass plate, that is equal to, you add all numbers, 2.40 plus 2.41 plus 2.41 plus 2.41 divided by 4 readings. No, therefore if you add and divide, we may get 9.62 by 4. Then it is thickness T is equal to maybe 2.40 millimeter it is, or you say in meters, then it is 10 power, you want to say in centimeters, then it is 10 power 0 minus 1 centimeter, like this. Okay, this is the length. Suppose you say breadth, yes, of course, we can also get breadth also by using this, by using a screw gauge. Okay, least count is to be like this. Clear? It is a thickness we know now. Is it okay now? This is the way we have to find the thickness of a given a glass plate by using a screw gauge. So like other one also is there, length. We need to find a length also of a given a cylinder. After knowing length, we can also find a volume also, volume of the cylinder. Clear? So that here you take a again volume same way you do the same experiment. Again, you take the given a cylinder, you put in this, but it's we cannot put because it is a bigger one is there. You take the cylinder, you can put in this, again you rotate it, after closing, once you rotate, after that you note down the readings, like 2-3 readings, then you take an average value, then we'll get the length of the cylinder. After knowing the length, we can also get the volume, because the volume of the cylinder is equal to, we can say pi r square L, or we'll get by using the vernier. Radius of the cylinder we can find, we can get from the by using a this vernier. After knowing r, after knowing length L, then you substitute v is equal to pi r square L, then we'll get the volume of the cylinder. So like this, the experiment which related to what it is to find the given volume of the given cylinder and thickness of the given glass plate. Clear? So this is the way we can take as the experiment 2. It is related to the screw gauge. So that this is the second experiment is finished, and you go through this video. Okay. Thank you very much. We'll see in the next class with a new experiment. Thank you.